from my side. Right, and let me share the screen. Right, okay, fine. So if you see here, I want to create a group login for SQL DBS. Okay, so I just opened, right click, new login, then I just selected Windows authentication. By default it was selected. Then I'm typing SQL DBS. Okay, imagine I want to create a group login for SQL DBS. I just typed SQL DBS. If I go for check names, I'll get the error like this. Okay, and usually what we have to do as we are creating group logins, here we have to select the groups. Okay, here we have to select the groups in the object types. You have to select the groups and click OK. And if you just click on check names, okay, then again you can see the error. Okay, this is like error. Okay, right, just 1 minute, so please don't mind, just 1 minute. Right, okay, fine. So I'm getting the error. Why? Because SQL DBA group is not existed in the Windows level. That's why I'm getting the error. Now, once I created the SQL DBA group, so that I won't get this kind of error. So let me create a SQL DBA group. How can I create a group login? Can anyone tell me how can I create a group in the Windows level? You know the shortcut?
Yeah. Local users and then create a group there.
Very good. Okay, same shortcut, lusr.mgr.msc. Earlier we have created a single user, right? So what you have to group means what? Collection of users, right? So first of all, we have to create users, then we have to create group, then we have to add those users into the group, then we can create a group login in the SQL server. Here you can see users and groups, right? So in the last class, we have only created a single user, Sean. Let me create 3-4 users today. Okay, so that once 3 people are created, I'll create a group login. Okay, then based on that, I'll create a Windows login in the SQL server, group login in the SQL server. Let me go like this. Okay, let me create 3 users here, new user, something like this. I'll go by, okay, randomly, I'll pick some students. Okay, remember, again, don't give different passwords in different scenarios. Choose only one password throughout your course. Otherwise, you will forget. Why? Because we have to give almost 20 to 30 passwords. Okay, I'm creating users. Okay, Anil created money. Okay, I'm creating 3 users simply. And again, it's not our headache. Windows people are going to take care of it. We won't have permissions to create these groups or individual users in the organization. Okay, right, money, then based on that we have Karthik, right, Karthik, and giving password, give strong password, minimum 8, 1 caps, 1 small, 1 number. Okay, and I'm selecting, yes, I have created 3 users, close it. You can see all the 3 users, Karthik, Manish, or Anil. Okay, let me create a group now. Okay, go to groups. Here, right click, new group. Okay, I'll give the group name as SQL DBS. These 4 people are SQL DBS. Okay, you can add the users now. Why? Because I have already created users, Mani, Karthik, Anil, right? I'm going to add all these people. Sean is already there, semicolon, Mani, semicolon, Karthik, semicolon. I want to add all people at a time. Okay, and then we have Anil. Okay, then check names. Then you can see what happened, Karthik. Okay, Karthik spelling is wrong. Okay, K-A-R-T-H-I-K, right, Karthik. Okay, now again check names. Now you can see all the names came, computer name slash username. Okay, computer name slash username, computer name slash username, computer name slash username. Now all 4 people are added to the SQL DBA group. Just create the group. Right, now group is created. You can see the group now. Here is the group. Clear? Now the group is created, SQL DBA group. And who are the members of this group? 4 people are members of, as of now, these 4 people are members of this SQL DBA team. Tomorrow, one more person can come into the team. Honey came into the company. newly recruited person, Hani. Hani just came into the company. So what we will do, we'll redirect Hani. Hey Hani, we have a SQL DBA group. Please raise a request to the Windows team so that Windows team are going to add you into the SQL DBA group. As a DBS, we won't have permissions to add any new person to the existing group. Only Windows people will add. Once Hani got her elevated account, she will request the Windows team, hey, please add my account to the SQL DBA AD group. Then anyone from Windows team pick the ticket and they are going to add Hani to the SQL DBA group. Adding Hani to the SQL DBA group is very easy. As already account is created for Hani, imagine Hani is newly joined, right? What they will do, you know, simply they will create a new user for Hani. Hani, right. Let me give the credentials. Right. And user must not change password. This one created, right? Hani is created now as a user. Now, what they will do, they will go to the groups. We just requested, right, SQL DBA group. They will search for the SQL DBA group. They will simply add Hani here. Check names. Hani came, then click OK. That's it. Okay, that's it. Like this. Now, whatever permissions are there for this SQL DBS group, again, no need to give separate permissions to the Hani now. This group will have group policies. This group will have group, every group will have group policies. Okay. This group can access only some set of servers. Like that, if Windows people set the group policy, automatically Hani is inherited the permissions of the group. Hani will get all the permissions. What are this group is having permissions? All the permissions are inherited by the Hani. Hani will get all the permissions. Now nothing to do from the SQL end. That's it. Okay. Let me create a group login now.
Sorry to disturb.
No problem. Tell me.
Here, what are the permissions do we have that particular group? How to check those permissions?
We cannot check it. Okay. Why? Because I told you, right? This is the work of the Windows team. In case if the login is created in the SQL server, then we can check the permissions. We cannot check by default. We don't have access to this window. We cannot create users. We cannot create groups as a SQL DBS. Windows team will do this activity. But for our practice, for our sessions, we are the Windows team. We are the network team. We are everything, right?
Okay.
So that's why we are creating the users and groups in the Windows level. Usually, I don't know why, because I never worked on the Active Directory setup. I don't know how to check whatever permissions are there to this group. As of now, this is a fresh group, right? No permissions are there. I can say that one. Why? Because this is very fresh group. Just now we have created, right? So I didn't give any permissions to this group. So this is very fresh group. This group doesn't have any permissions now. This, they can log into the Windows machine with their credentials. That's it. Okay.
Can you?
Okay.
Yeah. Yes.
Can you right click on this group?
Yeah.
Can you right click on this group? Go to properties.
Yes.
Okay. Here, this not showing any. Group policies or what kind of permissions?
Yeah. Okay. Yes, fine. So this, nothing this to worry about it. Yeah. This is different. Somewhat different. Okay. Locally,
Is there any limit on that particular group in SQL level? I'm not asking about Windows level.
In SQL level, no limit.
Is there any limit? No limit.
All the group persons can be a sysadmin. If the group is created as a sysadmin, all the members of that group also can become a sysadmin. They can do whatever they want in the SQL server level. If we give sysadmin access to the group. Okay. There is no limit. Right. Okay. So let me create a Windows login, group login. Okay, go to your SQL server, right click on the logins, new login. Like how you created a individual login, Windows login, in the same way we'll create the group login also. Search. Okay, as we are creating group login, you have to select the groups here so that it is going to search from the existing groups. Okay, if you don't select groups, see here what happened, you know, simply if you type SQL DBS, okay, you will get this error, this kind of error. Okay, right. Go to this object types, select the group so that Now Windows machine will search the existing groups also. Now check names. Now you can see computer name slash group name. In the organization, as you have created a group in the Windows machine so that the location is the computer name. This is the computer name, which was highlighted is the computer name. In the organization, you have to simply select the entire directory. Okay, there you can see one option called entire directory. Then once you have selected that entire directory, then you can get the group details. Again, nothing to worry. I'll show you in the Active Directory setup. Okay, we have Active Directory. Once we configured Active Directory, then I'll show you what to select here. Okay, so as of now, I got my group results. Click OK. In case you want to add this group login to sysadmin, you can simply select sysadmin. So that now you can see, right, 5 people are added to this group. Honey, Anil, Sean, and we have Kartik. Okay, these people, whoever added to this group, they all will become sysadmins in the SQL Server level. Whatever they want, they can do in this server. They can create the database, they can create the database, they can delete the databases, they can shut down the SQL Server, they can restart the SQL Server. Whatever they want, they can do it. Sysadmin, right? We are giving sysadmin privileges, right? That's why they can do whatever they want in the SQL Server level. Clear? I am not giving any sysadmin permissions to them. Just simply, okay, I'm going to create a group login for them.
Hello, Shenmukh, not audible.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah, yes.
I'm sorry for that. Okay. I have some limited internet connectivity. Okay. So that's why it is disconnecting multiple times. Yeah. Thanks for the confirmation. Okay. Right. So you have to simply click OK. Then automatically your group login will be created like this. Now I have a question for all of you. These are my logins in the SQL Server. Only these people can connect to my SQL Server. What it means? Those who are the members of the logins list, only those people can connect to my SQL Server. Now tell me, how to identify the difference between a Windows login, a SQL login, a group login? How can you identify this is a Windows login or a group login or a SQL login? How you can identify? Just by looking the name.
You can find a group of people there.
Okay, very good. If you see here
for
the
SQL
icon.
Login. Yeah. For icon. Yeah.
Yes. Yes, honey.
So for SQL login, you can for SQL login, you would be able to see SQL at the front. Mm-hmm. For Windows, you would be able to see Windows at the front, and for group, you would be able to see Windows and the group name at the last.
Okay, for SQL login, where I can see SQL at the front?
So SQL login, SQL at the front, yeah, SQL Server kind of thing. You would see.
Mm-hmm. Where
for
is
SQL
that?
Login.
Can you help
I
me?
I did test. Let me just because I remember doing a test. You would be able to see something like SQL Server.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
Icon, sir. Something like that. Icon.
Mm-hmm. Individual.
I don't think so. You do have any? You don't have any SQL Server.
SQL logins. We haven't created SQL logins. Any?
We did, but I couldn't see now.
Okay.
We did.
So we can easily identify a group login and an individual login. Group login will have a group of people with server. Okay. This is your group login. And individual logins, you have only one user in the icon, right? This is the difference between group login and Windows login. And what is the difference between Windows login and SQL login? How can you identify a Windows login and a SQL login? Very easy. We have already discussed in the last class. How can you identify a Windows login?
There is nothing in front of the login.
Very good. Okay. Windows name, machine name followed by the user name. Okay. So if you see computer name or machine name, this is your Windows login. If you see an individual name, that is your SQL login. There is no computer name here. Okay. So for Anil, there is no computer name. For Mani, there is no computer name. That means this is a SQL login. If you want to see, double click on it. Go to the, okay. Yeah, you can see here only SQL Server is authentic. SQL Server authentication is highlighted. Okay, and if you want to see the Windows login, this is my Windows login. You can see Windows authentication is highlighted here. Of course, it was grayed out. We cannot change after creation of the login. We cannot change from Windows to SQL, SQL to Windows. It was grayed out now. Honey, clear? Okay, so Windows login will have computer name, your Windows login followed by the computer name, and your SQL login, it will exist independently. There is no computer name. And group login, of course, you can see group of people in the icon. That is your group login. Clear? Any issues, any doubts? So creating group login is nothing. Simply how you are creating a Windows login, in the same way we'll create the group login also. Only one setting is you have to simply give the group name instead of individual login. And you have to choose what I have to choose. Okay, you have to choose object types as a group so that it is going to search the groups. Then only it is going to pull the groups related information and all. Any issues, any doubts as of now? Is it clear? Any doubts? Okay, so this is how we are going to create. Later someone joined in the company. Okay, later Geeta joined in the company. Okay, now maybe after 1 year, Geeta as a DBS, she joined in the company. She got the job. She joined in the company. Now what we will do? Nothing we will do. What Geeta has to do? Geeta has to raise a request to the Windows team. Hey, Windows team, please add me into the SQL DBS group. Windows team, they are going to add Geeta into the SQL DBA group. Okay. Once they created Geeta, then already a group login is created. This group login may have SQL DB, sysadmin permissions or else different permissions. Once Windows people are added Geeta into the SQL DBS group, nothing we have to do from our side. Simply, as Geeta is a member of SQL DBS group, now Geeta can happily connect to the SQL Server with the respective permissions. Earlier, imagine if there is no group login concept. Windows people has to create the Windows user for Geeta in the Active Directory. Then again, we have to go to the SQL Server. Again, we have to go to the new login, and again, we have to create a new login for Geeta. And again, we have to see the permissions and we have to give the permissions. Don't know, right? Geeta is a member of which team, or else already the team is having what kind of access, we don't know, right? Again, we have to search it using a customizer queries and all. Then based on that, we have to give permissions to Geeta, which is a headache process. Now, if anyone joined in the group or in the team, nothing to do from the DBA end. SQL DBA side, nothing. Simply, they have to request. They will raise a request. I need permissions on this database, on this server. We'll see, okay, she is newly joined, or else maybe she got promoted. Now she want to access different databases with the different privileges. Simply, we'll ask her, hey, please raise a request to the Windows team, or please check with the Windows team. Ask them to add in this particular SQL DBA role, or else group, okay? Once Geeta contacted Windows team will add Geeta into the SQL DBA role. Again, Windows team won't connect to the SQL Server and they won't add it from here. They will simply open lusr-mgr.msc. They will see the SQL DBA group. They will add the Geeta in the SQL DBA group. That's it. Automatically, now Geeta can connect to my SQL Server. No need to create Geeta login again in the SQL Server. Now Geeta can connect to the SQL Server and she can access the SQL Server with the group permissions. What are this group is having privileges? All privileges will be inherited by Geeta. Clear? Any issues in the group logins concept?
Shinma?
Yes.
For example, user will raise the request to create the login with his name.
Okay.
In particular server.
Okay.
Which level we will create the login? Windows level or SQL Server level?
The SQL level only. By default, it's SQL logins only we'll create. We won't create Windows logins.
SQL.
Okay. Yes, SQL logins only.
Password.
Password we are going to share. We are going to share the password. Okay, see here. Earlier we have already discussed that one. New login, SQL login. Okay. Imagine, yeah. I want to create a SQL login Geeta. Okay. If I give the password, okay, something like I'm giving one password. Okay, 123. And .123 is the password for Geeta. Okay. If you see here, user must change password at next login. Okay. This option is we have already selected this option, right? Don't uncheck this option, let it be and click OK. Then once Geeta whatever password I gave now, I'll just forward to Geeta. Geeta, this is your password. Geeta, first time she will log in with the default password that was given by the DBA team. Once she just logged into the SQL server, once that is a successful login, Geeta is prompted with the new password. Hey, please change the password. Old password, new password, confirm password. Immediately she is going to get a screen. So we don't know the Geeta's password. Only while creation, we know the Geeta's password. Why? Because we have to give the password, right? After once she just tried login with the default password, immediately it will prompt Geeta to change the password. So there is no question of knowing the other's password. Even I'm a DBA also. Clear? Fine, right? Any doubts? Yeah. Right. So that's it. This is how we are going to create an individual login, SQL login, Windows login, and
yes, sir.
Group login. Yes, yes.
And out.
Yes. Yes, man.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Can we? Yes, sir. Can we check if there are four members, right? Like Mani, Anil, four users.
Very good. Right? Very good. Yes. Let me tell you one query. Okay.
So.
Yes. Yes. I got your question. Okay. Now Mani got a doubt. I want to see who are the members of this group login. Okay. SQL DBA group is already created, right? Why? Because it is very important. Yes. Sometimes we have to know who are there in this group. Okay. We have to know what are the members are there in this group as a SQL DBA. So we have a query for that, xp_. Okay. What is that? Login info, I guess. Okay. xp_ login info. Just drag and drop this group. Okay. Comma. Members. I want to see all the members of this group, right? Comma members. Just write down this query and you can see all the users of this group. Okay. Anil, Hani, Kartik, Mani, and Sean. If you see here, if you go to the group also, you can see the same people only. Anil, Hani, Kartik, Mani, Sean. All five people, you can see the five people here. So in this way, in case, this is important. Why? Because sometimes you want to see Geeta is already added to the group, but Geeta is claiming that I'm unable to access the database. Now as a DBA, you have to troubleshoot why she is unable to, but Geeta is saying Windows people redirected to this DBA team. They said that they added me into the SQL DBS group, but still I'm unable to access. We have to check, right? Geeta is added or not. So in this, by using this query, xp_ login info group name comma members, we can check who are the members of the SQL DBA group. Okay, in case if there is a different group, we have to change the group name. That's it. Simply we have to change the group name. Then you can see who are the members. In case if I found Geeta here, I'll connect to the Geeta directly. I'll see what error she is getting. Maybe she is wrongly using the management studio, or else she is giving a wrong username, wrong password. I'll start troubleshooting. But if I see there is no Geeta here, I'll simply take the screenshot. Hey Geeta, maybe they are added into the different group by mistake. See here, you are not in this group. So just please check with them. I can directly route Geeta to the Windows team. Okay, this is the query to check who are the members of any group. Clear?
Yes, sir. But while connected to any server, it will show
not SQL DBA. It will show individual. In case you want, I'll show you. Okay. That's what we haven't created a SQL DBA login. Yeah. There is a difference in SQL DBA login. Say, for example, let me create a login like this. Okay. SQL authentication. SQL. Okay. DBS. Right. Click OK. What is this password? Okay. Password I didn't give, right? Let me give 123 password, 123 password. As I'm giving small password, let me uncheck this password policy. Right. Now, Mani, remember, this is different. This is different. Okay. This is completely different. Why? Because in case 10 people wants to access, how can they access? They know this is a common login and a common password. This common login, common password will be shared to those 10 people. And all will connect like this only, SQL DBA login name and the password which was shared to them. So that if anyone connected, say for example, now you are on the shift, now you choose SQL Server authentication, now you gave SQL DBAs and now you gave password, now you connected. Now what you can see here, you can see SQL DBAs login only. you cannot see your name. Why? Because you are using SQL DBS login here to log into the SQL server. This is different and this is different. Okay, some people, yes, very small companies, what they will do, they will create a common login and they will ask us to use the same login in case 10 people are there in the group. But the problem is...
I'm not asking about login, sir. I mean SQL Server login. I'm asking about Windows login. SQL DBS...
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. I want to show the difference between those two. Okay? I want to show the difference between those two. In case, if it is like this, in case if they provided a common login, okay, in case if you just log in with the common login, it will show you just SQL DB is connected. SQL DB may be a money, SQL DB may be money like Anil or Geeta, someone else, but you cannot see the individual username here. Let's try with this group login, okay? For that, what we have to do, let me open SQL Server Management Studio with a different user, okay? Right click Management Studio, shift and hold the Management Studio, you can see the different user. Now, who are the members of the SQL DBA? Who are the members of the SQL DBA? They can connect to the SQL Server. Imagine, let me go with the money, okay? Money, and I'm giving the password for money. Right? Now, money can connect to the SQL Server or not? Can anyone tell me?
Yes, sir, he can connect.
Why? Because he is a member of SQL DBA group. Again, no need to create a separate individual account for money. Then what is the use of the group login for that? That's why as money is a member of SQL DBA group, SQL DBA is already created in the SQL server with the default permissions. So money can connect to the existing instance with his own name, money. Why? Because while opening, we are giving money username and money password. So in case if you connect to the SQL server, automatically it will show you the money username, okay, beside the instance name, so that you can easily understand who are connected to. See here, you can see here money will be opened, okay, money. See here, money. In case if I connect, you can see here money is connected, okay. If you expand this one, money is connected and we can easily identify it. So anyone joined from the group, as they are particular members of that particular group, they can easily, they can only log in with their username and password. They cannot log in like this with a common username and password.
Yes, sir. Got
they
it.
Can log in with their own name and password. So then only you can connect to the SQL server. Then you can easily identify who are connected, who are doing what kind of things and all.
Yeah. Shanmukh, I have a small query. You have created login like SQL DBS, right?
Mm-hmm.
It is directly created on SQL end.
Yes.
Okay. If, for example, as you said, if small companies, they are doing like that.
Mm-hmm.
For example, there are five members who are able to access that particular SQL DBA. How to capture? For example, the mistake was done somewhere, something else.
We cannot capture.
How to capture that?
Actually, that is not a recommended.
Is there any activity capture?
How can you capture? See, for example,
okay,
Ankam Rao, two Ankam Raos are there with same initials. Okay. Both connected to the SQL server, someone dropped the object. Okay. In the error log, it will show you Ankam Rao dropped the object. It won't show you the particular name. As we both are people, five people are connected using the same username and password, it will simply show you SQL DBA dropped the object. Don't know, we have to like ask each and every person, or else we have to do some RCA, who connected by that time, who is there in the shift. Okay. Five people may be there in the shift, two people may be there in the shift, based on the error log, at what time it was generated, based on that, who is connected to the particular SQL Server DBA, SQL Server database, then based on that, we can troubleshoot. But you cannot find out on behalf of SQL DBA, Ankam Rao is connected and Ankam Rao deleted using SQL DBA login. In the error log, it will show you SQL DBA is deleted the object, but it won't show you Ankam Rao deleted the object. Got it?
But when we are connecting via Windows,
yes. Windows
it will show
you
like,
yes,
like
it will
money.
Track you. Yes, it will track you. Of course, it has to track. I just now you can see the difference, right? This is showing money and this is showing simply SQL login. Okay? If you connected like this, it is showing SQL login. If five people are connected, it will show SQL DBS only as a username. Okay, clear?
Yeah, got it. Thank you.
Okay, so remember this query. This is very important. Sometimes we have to check who are the members of this particular group. Okay, so that you can check using this stored procedure. Okay, XP underscore login info. So using this one, you can check it. Okay, all right. Any questions here as of now? Is it clear?
Can you share that query via chat?
Yes. I'll share. Okay, don't worry about it. Any issues? Any doubts as of now? Is it clear? Guys, let me know in case if you're facing any issues. Okay, fine. Don't try to execute the same query. Why? Because my computer name is different. Maybe your computer name will be different. Okay, so you will get the error if you try to execute the same query. Right, fine. So that's it from the login side. That is how we are going to create a SQL login, Windows login, and a group login. Right. So apart from logins, we have to discuss about the server roles. Okay, so we have server roles in the server level and we have database roles in the database level. Okay, if you expand the security there, beside below to the logins, you can see the server roles. Okay, if you expand the server roles, you can see 8+1 server role, total 9 server roles will be there. Okay, I'll tell you why I said 8+1. Okay, public is not a known fixed server role. Public doesn't have any permissions. Okay, by default, every login is a member of public server role. If you see here, we have created a lot of logins, right? If you go to the SQL login, Windows login, any login, if you go to server role, everyone will be selected as a public. Okay, if you uncheck this one, you cannot uncheck. By default, public server role doesn't have any permissions, but by default, if you create any login, this login is a member of the server role. Okay, public server role, any login, if you see any login, I didn't give any permissions to the SQL DBS, but if you see SQL server roles, public will be selected by default. This will have only one permission, that is connect to SQL permissions will be there. That's why whenever a dummy login or whenever a normal login is created, how come he can connect to the SQL server without giving any access? As each login is a member of public role will have only connect, by default, connect permission. Even though you are not giving a direct connect permission, if you create a normal login without giving any permission, still he can able to connect to the SQL server, means by default, each login will have connect to SQL permission. They can only connect, they cannot do anything. If you see here, Mani's SQL DBS is already connected, right? He cannot expand any database. He will get the error. Why? Because he is not an authorized user to expand the databases, to use the databases, to see the databases. Okay. So by default, each and every login will have connect permission to the SQL server. Other than that, they cannot do anything. Okay. So let's discuss about the server roles. After that, we'll discuss about the database roles also, where you can see the database roles. If you expand any database, if you expand the security, one more security will be there in the database level. If you expand the database, in the security, there you can see database roles. This is 9+1. Okay. Again, you will have public database role in the database roles, public server role in the server role as well. Okay. We'll discuss those things. Nothing to worry. Right. Let's start with the server roles. What is the server roles? So, server roles means simply, okay, collection of permissions is called a role. Collection of permissions is called a role. If you see here, we have different roles, 8+1 role, right? Forget about public. We have bulk admin, DB creator, disk admin, process admin, security admin, server admin, setup admin, and sysadmin. Finally, we have sysadmin. Sysadmin means, guys, sysadmin can do anything. Okay. So usually what we will do is, based on the user's requirement, we are going to add logins to this particular server roles. Like I told you right earlier, group login concept, whatever that group is having permissions, once you add it to that particular group, you are going to get all the permissions that group is having. In the same way, server roles will have a set of permissions. Once I added you into the server role, you will get all the permissions. For example, bulk admin will have different permissions. DB creator will have different permissions. Once I added Mani into the DB creator role, whatever permissions are there for DB creator, the money will have all the permissions. In the same way, if I added money into the bulk admin will have different permissions. DB creator will have different permissions. And disk admin will have different permissions. Process admin will have different permissions. Each role will have its own permissions. If money, I want to make money as a sysadmin, simply I can add money into the sysadmin role. No. I cannot give money permissions. Money, I cannot make money as a sysadmin. I want money is completely different. His work is completely different. His roles and responsibilities are completely different. Based on his roles and responsibilities, based on his work, I'll add money to the bulk admin or DB creator or process admin or security admin. Based on the work, I'm going to add money into the respective role. So in case I want to see what are the permissions are there for each role, I should know, right? Bulk admin will have what kind of permissions? DB creator will have, in case if I added bulk admin, if I added money into the bulk admin role, what he can do? If I added money into the DB creator, what he can do? So I have to know, right? So for that, we have a query. Okay, what is that query? SP underscore SRV role permission. Okay, once you run this, once you write this query, the color will be changed. In case instead of permission, you gave permissions. Again, it went to back color, black color, and you can see a red mark here. Okay, that means what? This stored procedure is wrong. Okay, remove this one. You can see red. Sorry.
We lost you.
Okay. Okay, fine. Is it clear now? Is it clear? Everyone is facing same issue with my audio.
Now it is work. Okay.
Now it is clear.
No.
So the meeting is going to close now. Let me reopen the meeting. Please join the meeting with the same link. Okay. Meeting is going to close now. Let me reopen the meeting.